And welcome back to Let's Play Phantasy Star Generation 2. We're heading to the Crevasse in this episode, and after that, the Esper Mansion. The Crevasse is really just a point, a way to get there. And we're in Ockbar, so really simple to get there if you're in Ockbar. Just basically head this way, up here, and down. A sky tiara? I've never seen you here in these here parts. So let's kill you. That's an owl. Why is it a tiara? I couldn't even evade that one. That was easy. Okay. Down here. Jeez. Oh, that tracer base thing again. We just have all these single enemies. Take him downtown. Okay, you're looking for this hole here. And sheesh. I should have brought one of those covert ocarinas with me. I might have one. I'm not sure. Oh, I forgot to paralyze it, damn it. It looks like it has stereo speakers. Okay. I haven't played this for a while. I was afraid I wouldn't get the defenses down. But, you know, the episode's early. I can always screw up some more. No, we're actually very close to where we're supposed to go. Right here, see this? Did you miss it? I got in the fight trying to show you guys. You can see the little lip there. You guys probably could see it. Yeah, I missed it. Ow. Missed? She took it out with 2 points. What are the odds? Right there. All I have to do is press forward and there it is. Oh, the crevasse. Let me just see where I am, because what's it say? B1F or something? Must be getting another fight. B1F, yeah. Oh, I see where I am. Okay, we really don't have to go far then. We're near the north section of it, and to leave here, we have to go even more north. But there's a chest pretty much to the west of here, so I'm gonna hit that, of course. Hungry apes. I don't care how hungry you are, we are not your food. You healed nothing, sir. Damn it. Nice, one hit. He's like rolling his eye, like, yeah, that hurt. 6, oh yeah. We'll get to go first and take him out. If you can avoid getting hit by them, then yeah. That's the way you do it. A little touch up here. Saving for posterity. Was that chest? Right on the other side of this thing here. Now this isn't the stairs you want, but you might want 9200 Messina. Alright, let me take a look at something here. That's a cliff. And that falls down. Huh? Okay, we're back where we were. See? Let me fall down again. There's a dead end with a chest. Yeah, I mean, you could spend forever walking through all this crap, but I'm just gonna head to where we're supposed to go. Mammoths hit really hard. With the defense with that. Good. Only 55 damage. Kill it. And leveled up and maybe got a new technique, I'm not even sure. I couldn't see it, it flew back so fast. Alright. Head for the stairs that we need. It's on this side. Oh. No, it isn't. It's here. V? That's all you are, is V? Yeah, kind. If you could. Paralyze this huge-looking, scary thing. A scary-looking, huge thing. Thank you. That's his top back. 39 on that. I think Eustace's sword is more useful against living opponents. Okay, B2F. We are here. Yeah, I know exactly where we are. We're gonna hit a chest. Oh, I think I know how to get to that. Okay. There's an item that I wanted to get to with a dead end. I think I know how to get there. Anyway, we have to walk quite a way to get all the way around here. Malefic Eye. Those are three-eyed crows. I mean, owls. So, I didn't notice that all of them have three eyes. Ah! Damn it! Oh, I missed all of the fences! Good. Ah, still though. Sheesh. So I have to say, guys, you're looking for a contender of the hardest turn-based RPG game ever? I think we have our winner here. Between the monsters you fight are like unbalanced, and all the freaking mazes, and the amount that that you run into battles, the random battles, is just crazy to begin with. If, you know, most other RPGs, if they were this tough, the battles, they would be less frequent. And they wouldn't have freaking mazes where you go insane. As it is, if I wasn't following maps, I don't know. I wouldn't be this far along in the game, that's for sure. And I'd be pulling my hair out. So, I'd probably be mapping everything out. Or figuring out how to get from one place to another, and then going from there. But anyway, she's running low on techniques. Let me just use some items. And yeah, she's not really low, but she's halfway, and it's pretty early still. I'm gonna skip that, and I'm just gonna, That's good for her. Okay. Between the things of doom, just for no reason, the columns of doom there. 12,800 Meseta, nice. We're down around the corner here. Okay, so if you go up here, I believe it's a dead end, but there is a item to get. I think. Right this way. Oh god. Freaking owl killed Eustace, my god. Oh look. Interesting, because he's not here, we can't consult. That's interesting. Technique for Anne. This is why it's good to have her with hit points. Unfortunately, we can only do this once, unless I get her technique points back. Yeah, they hit us hard, those freaking things. My god. The freaking, you dig? Why the hell not? 14,200 Meseta. I think it's worth it. Boop. Okay, so we're back on B2. And we need to go... to the east and south. Okay, B3. There's a goodie. I'm not sure which way to go here, but I know where the goodie is. The Zorian Mammoth. It went faster, ow. It went faster than the others. It went first. Even with our, you know, top attacks, the mammoths have been going after Rutger. Ow. Have Eustace use some points. Goody! 8,800 Meseta. Now... Rutger leveled up. Okay, so if I go this way... Well, there is a stairs. I'm not sure if we're supposed to take these, though. Just a B2F? I'm not sure. But if we go down this way... I think there's also stairs. Okay, Eustace leveled. Oh no, there's nothing. Okay, so it's gotta be that stairs. I need to heal Kynes pretty badly. Good thing I just remembered. Plenty of technique points. We might be getting close to getting the hell out of here, so... Air Tearer. By the way, I was supposed to go up those stairs. I started moving back. I didn't go up yet. That's the problem with all these battles. They make you forget what you were doing before the battle. Uh-oh. Going first. Ooh, 92 points. Oof. We really can't take much of that. Oh, miss. Oh my god, we're sucking. That is kind of normal for Anne and her thing, though. Her, staff. That's a little better. Well, not that, but... Still 200 points on this thing. Kill Eat! Can I get rid of it like this? Evidently not. 6 points. Now I can. Wait. Did I go? Wait. Did I go up the thing? I don't even know what the hell I did. Oh, I did go up. Never mind. I did go up those stairs. Saving. I don't think this... Ugh. Maybe? B1. Well, we can get another goodie. I just don't know... Oh. Where the hell are we? Okay, never mind. No goodie here. Just gonna save here, cause... I see it! Just gotta get rid of these droll monkeys. They're so droll, I tell ya. Oh, he stole his technique points! See that? That's a cruel thing to do, to steal someone's technique points. He's frat. Well, I hope we can warp back from here. Speed that up. There you go. How about that, huh? Oh! It's you! We have been expecting you for quite some time. Acolytes. Just as he foretold, we have been waiting for you. Waiting for you! Well, let's explore this place, I guess. Okay. Stairs down. People. A throne. Let's talk to all these guys. He told us he would awaken upon your visit. It has been 10 years since he began his latest slumber. When he awoke 10 years ago, he tried to save the lives of those killed in an accident. In truth, Mother Brain arranged their deaths. He decided to hide on this planet after Mother Brain was created. These guys don't say anything else. 400 years ago, he awoke from his long slumber. Mother Brain was already extending her influence across planet Palma. She assured its people an easy, charmed life. Its cities had unprecedented growth. He must have sensed the danger. He gathered the espers of Algol together. They fled here and established this mansion. He who sleeps here saved Algol from a great evil long ago. Can I see this thing? Okay, we just go down. Welcome. We are his disciples. We have been expecting you. We, his loyal disciples, have been patiently waiting for your arrival. And behold. Look familiar, guys? The awoken man says, I'm glad you have made it this far. I am Miseris Lutz Issa Lalai. If you prefer, you may simply call me Lutz. I may very well be the last Esper in Algol. Now, for those who may not recall, he appeared in Phantasy Star Generation 1, and of course, which is the remake, originally appeared in Phantasy Star, the first game. So he was one of the characters that you brought with your party with Alice and Meow, and depending on the game, it was Tyrone or Tyron. Or, Noah. So, he's... I might have it wrong, guys. I'm not sure. I think Noah is Lutz's name in the other game. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, so... He was in the game. The magic user. I may very well be the last Esper in Algol. You are Eusis, I presume? Hmm? Are you wondering how I know your name? You do not remember me. This is the second time we have met. The second time? Yes. You were 10 years old. You accompanied your parents on a spaceship tasked with planetary exploration outside of Algol. There was an accident. That is when we first met. Huh? I woke up at that moment. I summoned the light of Tajim and revived you. The light of Tajim? Sounds better. It is the embodiment of my old master's power. But how? Why? Why did you save me? In truth, the voice of Elisa roused me from my deep sleep. Elisa? Alice. Yes, you are her descendant. Your ancestor, Elisa, Alice Landale, was a great heroine who fought hard to save Algol. Alice Landale? You have seen her before, Lutz says. In your nightmare, she represents beautiful Algol fighting against an evil being. That entity is Dark Falls. Dark Falls. Dark Falls is the manifestation of a profound evil. It conspired against Algol, plotting our demise from the shadows. However, Dark Falls was no match for Elisa's might. After 1,000 years, Dark Falls has returned. Long ago, I summoned my fellow Espers here. We knew this day would come. We combined our power to create a series of weapons and armor capable of defeating Dark Falls. We sealed them in towers that we have hidden behind gravitational fields. The towers are invisible to all. Eusis, you must retrieve the weapons and armor. This arrow prism will disrupt the gravitational field and let you access the towers. Nay is an ancient, hallowed name that has come to mean negation. In other words, the neutralization of evil. What a coincidence. If you bring the Nay items before me, I will recognize you, Eusis, as Elisa's rightful heir. A word of caution. Once you use the arrow prism to reveal the towers, Mother Brain will detect them immediately. You have a monumental task ahead of you. Now go. Acquire the Nay items before evil engulfs all of Algol. Got the arrow prism. Hold on, guys. Just a second. Let me close this window that's next to me. Okay. Hurry! Acquire the Nay items before evil engulfs all of Algol. Hurry, hurry. He feared so much for Algol that he decided to enter into cryogenic sleep to prolong his life so that he may protect us longer. Now, as you guys know, as you might know, because I mentioned, I did not play this far. I never got to this planet at all. I never got past the dams. So, Little did I know, if I would have like struggled through if I knew that I was going to a new freaking planet after the dams. But I expected more of the same. So in a way it is, but yeah, I would have struggled through. But anyway, yeah, so I never made it this far. It's only like fairly recently, like in the last 10 years or so, that I found out that Lutz makes an appearance in the game. Pretty cool. He has known from the very beginning that the great evil would return and threaten us all. Perhaps it is already upon us. He knew you would come, and so it begins. There is a hole in your mind. We have served him for generations. He is worried about the future of Algol. He has predicted that an evil force from the past will return. Perhaps it is already upon us. We are the only descendants of Espers left in Algol. Our ancestors had gathered here to serve him. Unfortunately, his power has waned. He is the last true Esper. Oh, we're back up top. You didn't realize that. What if we go back down? Where'd those extra people go? Because this was the same amount that was here, right? The future of Algol is in your hands. We will pray for your success on your arduous journey. You are the chosen ones. You are destined to save Algol. Yeah, no pressure or anything, you know. So, doesn't the music sound a little faster now? It seems faster to me. So I have to come back here a few more times, because when we get the items, at least once we have to come back. So look at this arrow prism. Shows buildings invisible to the naked eye. Cool. So I don't even know where the first one is. We might want to remain here. I have to look into it, guys. We could use a, you know, technique boost and stuff. So I'm gonna save here. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.